Have any of you seen that movie, Clerks 1? Like, when he keeps saying, like, I'm not even supposed to be here today. What is up, everybody? This is Chris from the Rewired Soul, where we talk about the problem, but focus on the solution. And if you're new to my channel's all about mental health, and I'm walking right now, so the lighting sucks. But anyways, my channel's all about mental health. Make sure you subscribe and ring that notification bell if that's what you're into. But anywho, I am in the process of moving right now with my beautiful girlfriend, Tristan, and I was gonna post this collab I did with Trey, but I was busy packing last night, so on one of my runs, I'm like, yo, camera's still out? Let's do this, because you know I'm all about that hustle. So yeah, anyways, a lot of you have asked me for videos about how like health, like the foods we eat and exercise is involved with like anxiety, depression, and mental health and all that. And Trey Jones is the man for that, okay? I'm gonna link his channel in the info card and down in the comments below and in the description. Go check out his channel, he's amazing. But anyways, I'ma shut up, here's Trey.
What is going on, guys? I got a good video for you today. 10 foods that help relieve anxiety. I'm about to get right into this. Go ahead and hit that like button down below if you're ready to kick anxiety in the butt and learn some amazing foods that you can start implementing into your diet, okay? 80% of these foods I consume on a regular basis. Why do I still do that, Trey? Why do I still work, you know, on my diet? Because not only do they help you overcome anxiety, it's some of the things that I did to overcome my personal issues with anxiety disorders. This works for anxiety disorders and depression, but it also helps me keep it away. If you have things, especially like major depression issues or health anxiety or panic disorder, okay, you're prone and more vulnerable to that returning and getting caught up in that vicious cycle that we are so familiar with, okay? So we wanna keep our diet on point. We wanna make sure that we're exercising and doing all the other tips that I give at the end of my videos. But today we are talking about foods, and the first one on the list, guys, is asparagus, okay? This is good baked with olive oil, okay? We will drizzle olive oil on it, put it on a cookie dish or a baking dish, excuse me. Spray that thing down with Pam so it don't stick. Put it in the oven, it's delicious that way. Or we throw it on a grill with steak and chicken. So freaking good. And then add a little crisp to it. But I usually during the week, I will just use these steam bags, okay? Very filling, only 60 calories, guys. It only takes 6 minutes to throw this in the microwave and heat it up. It's great steamed. A lot of people, actually most people, eat it steamed. This only has 60 calories, so that's amazing, all right? But the cool thing about this, guys, it's high in folic acid. It has 2/3 of your daily value in just one cup, okay? So it's easy to get the folic acid that's actually linked to lower depression levels, okay? People that are lower in folic acid tend to have depression issues more so than those that are on normal folic acid levels or higher. Okay, so something just to keep in mind, a nice green vegetable, very delicious, guys. The second one, guys, is oranges, okay? We know it boosts our immune system, that's great for our overall health, but you know it also helps lower your blood pressure and stress hormones. So if you have health anxiety and pain disorder, we are always worried about our blood pressure. People with anxiety tend to have higher blood pressure anyway, so this will help combat that. Also, it's gonna lower our stress hormones, so it's a double whammy. It also helps hydrate you. 80% of us are chronically dehydrated, and that does not help us out with our stress and anxiety, okay? It actually make our stress headaches much, much worse, or our anxiety hangovers. If anybody here drinks alcohol, you know what that's like. If you have anxiety, the next day you wake up, it is horrible. Make sure you stay hydrated. This has like a delayed hydration, which is great because not a lot of foods have that. LeBron James, one of my favorite basketball players, he was playing in a playoff game this past year. He left with cramps, had to get an IV. He came back with an orange because it has delayed hydration. It was gonna help him throughout the rest of the game. And he had an amazing game, okay? The next one, guys, a really, really cool one, is salmon, okay? Salmon is the fish that has the most omega-3. Now, you can get omega-3 from tuna and tilapia and other things, but salmon has the most, okay? This is good baked with some Old Bay seasoning. You can also grill it, okay? Now, I don't eat salmon all the time. I probably eat salmon once or twice every couple weeks, especially when I go on my health kicks. It's really, really good, but it's gonna keep your cortisol, your adrenaline levels down. So if you have panic attacks, this is great news for you. Try implementing some salmon, okay? Number four, spinach, okay? Here we go. I buy a lot of cans, but it's also good fresh. Now me and my wife, we will make a salad probably once every 2 weeks. It'll last us about 4 or 5 days. Now we put iceberg and romaine, but we always mix in a bunch of spinach leaves and they're really, really good. This right here, not only does it make me and Popeye go thunk, 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 but it's high in magnesium, and that's great for lowering cortisol and stress hormone levels. So it's going to help you out. Magnesium is one of them supplements that everybody tells you to get, but if you can get it the natural way, especially out of a green vegetable that's lower in calories, especially like spinach, this whole can right here is 90 calories and very, very filling, and I eat it with some hot sauce, very good, okay? Number five is a little treat that you can have or treat yourself to after a long, hard day and a really good meal, and it's dark chocolate. It has compounds that have been proven to help lower stress. Now, don't go overboard. Don't go crazy. Yeah, I said chocolate. It doesn't mean Butterfingers, Crunch Bars, Twix, all that stuff. I said dark chocolate and not in large amounts because too much sugar is not going to help with your anxiety, your weight, your overall health. Just not a good thing. So I would get a bag of them special dark Hershey's, the little tiny squares right there. You should just try that out, guys. Have one or two of those every day. Something to look forward to, a little treat. And we need those kind of things whenever we go through anxiety. All right, the sixth one, guys, is blueberries, okay? My one-year-old daughter loves these. She has them almost every single day as a snack or for breakfast. They're great with oatmeal, in case you're wondering. They are a superfood, which means they have vitamins, they have plant nutrients, and they have antioxidants. All this combined, guys, is great for our overall health and stress levels, okay? The seventh one is almonds. These are a healthy fat. Fats get a lot of bad reputation, but we need healthy fats, and this is one of them along with avocados. It contains zinc and iron, okay? And those help reduce brain fatigue. Anybody have brain fog? Many of you always come to me telling me, what can I do for my brain fog? This is something that you can do. Go buy a big bag of almonds, okay? Buy it in bulk because they can be pricey, but I get great value from Walmart. Find a good deal on them, okay? Eat a handful of them a day and tell me how you feel after a week or two, okay? Seriously, let me know, all right? They're gonna help you with brain fatigue. They also, aside from anxiety in general, almonds and other nuts and seeds have been known to be brain boosting, okay? They boost your brain power, okay? They're gonna help you be more sharp, more alert, multitask, things like that. So go grab some almonds. Number eight is turmeric, okay? It's a spice. I don't use it all the time, honestly. I'm gonna be completely honest with you. We have used it in a couple meals, but it's not always in our pantry. But something to try out, guys. It's good to add on certain meats and foods and chili and things like that. If you don't wanna do it like that, you can always put some on your teeth and gums. I've heard about this, and let your gums soak it up and do that every single day. So you can just pick up the spice bottle and do that. Also, a cool little fact that I had no idea until today, actually. Turmeric is one of the best teeth whiteners in the world, okay? So something to think about if you're into that. Number nine, one of my all-time favorites, avocado, another superfood. It is literally good on everything, okay? I even make my own guacamole, okay? I'll buy two or three avocados, cut them and mash them up. You can make it chunkier, smoother. Salt, pepper, cilantro, lime, tomato, onion. Oh, it's so freaking good. Stick in the fridge, it'll last me for about two or three days with some tortilla chips, since those aren't horrible for you. I actually get gluten-free tortilla chips, so they're even better for me. But it has a lot of vitamin B, and how many times at the end of my videos have I preached to you guys, vitamin B is amazing. Vitamin B6 and vitamin B12 help you with mood stabilization. This is where you can pick up some of that. It's also a healthy fat that we need, okay? Avocado, like I said, they're good on burgers, sandwiches, with your Mexican food, on tacos. Every single thing, it's good by itself, honestly. It's kind of acquired taste if you've never had it. I know a lot of people will, you know, just kind of dismiss it quickly. I wasn't a huge fan at first, but after I got used to it, it was really, really good. It's kind of an acquired taste, and it's a cool texture. I like it, it's different. Number 10, guys, is oatmeal. Had some oatmeal this morning for breakfast, actually. One of these packets right here is just 130 calories. It boosts your serotonin, so it's gonna give you that calm feeling. Also, it's very, very filling, which is good on your digestive system. If you have hunger pains or digestive issues, that adds to anxiety. So starting your day off with some oatmeal, you can add fruit to it. If you wanna do it the really, really healthy way, guys, which there's nothing wrong with this, but it's a little bit more processed than the other way, just buy you a big can of rolled oats. Sorry, I'm getting tongue-tied there. And then cut up your own fruit, like bananas or blueberries or strawberries or peaches. Add them in there, man, that would be amazing. Don't add a lot of sugar, guys. If you're gonna add any, just sprinkle some sugar at most. I wouldn't get crazy with that, guys, because sugar is just not good for you. So those are my top 10 foods to help relieve anxiety. For the bonus, guys, it's bananas. They're high in potassium, energy. They've been known to help with stress and anxiety. I have probably a banana for breakfast probably 3 to 4 days a week. And some days I'll have it in combination with my oatmeal or something else, okay? So it's really, really good for you. I suggest trying that out. Not only is it gonna help you with your potassium, but your energy levels. If you have anxiety hangovers, okay? It's also a huge remedy for that, okay? If you drink a lot of alcohol, it's gonna help you out. I'm not promoting that you drink a lot, but try a banana or two, preferably two, after you are hungover and watch the wonders that it does for you guys. Thank you so much for watching. Remember, leave me a comment down below if you've tried any of these or you're trying to try more of these or if you're gonna start a new diet plan today or tomorrow, let me know. Also, I'm into recipes, okay? So if there are any cool recipes that you have heard of or that you know or that you personally make or recommend, let me know down below that contain any of these. I know some of these you can combine together. Avocado is good with any type of meat, okay? Oranges and bananas are good together. Also, you can put your bananas in your oatmeal, so you can do a lot of different things. And these are not the only foods, guys, but these are my top 10 with that bonus number 11. Foods that I recommend.
Booyah! Did y'all learn some stuff? I know I did. And now that Tristan and I are moved and the gym is right next to me, I need to kick myself into gear and start getting back in the gym and eating right. Some of you have already called me out on Twitter and I love it. I love it so much. But oh yeah, by the way, I put up my second exclusive videos over on Patreon. So all of you patrons out there, go check it out. I did the first ever, like, since I'm moving, like, I showed where I live, my neighborhood, and all that kind of stuff. And I'm gonna do a video later about just, like, starting from nothing and building up, because you'll see where I lived. You'll see where I live. But anyways, if you're not a patron yet, $5 a month. $5 a month, you get a bunch of exclusive extra content. And what's that? It's like a cup of coffee. Cup of coffee, don't get it this month. Or just, yeah, don't get one cup of... You got this, you got this. Or just do a dollar, you know, whatever it is, whatever it is, all right? But yeah, anyways, go check out Trey's channel. He has a ton of stuff about health and anxiety. His whole channel is dedicated to anxiety. He also has a mental health support group that's way bigger than mine. He's actually one of the people who inspired me to do it. So go check out his channel. He's an amazing, amazing dude, has a ton of stuff about anxiety, all right? But yeah, like Trey said, leave some comments down below with suggestions or, you know, recipes or whatever that is, all right? So anyways, that's all I got for this video. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you're new, make sure you subscribe and ring that notification bell because I make a ton of videos. And a huge thank you to everybody supporting the channel over on Patreon. And boom, right over there, click or tap right there to go subscribe to Trey, all right? Thanks so much for watching. I'll see you next time.